Okay. Right, so this is the new bonfire. I don't want to go here yet because I want to check out the other way. That's also available in the, you know, in the undead settlement. So I want to check out this way first. And then maybe I should actually save the souls. Almost fell into this hole here. Maybe I should save the 20,000 souls for the key to the tower. Guess I'm gonna do that. I will also pause the stream by now, so the internet limit doesn't get sucked down so fast, you know, because at some point the quality of the stream might just become worse than. And this giant is still shooting his arrows. I wonder how it would actually get in there. Lizard there. Oh, there's bloodstains here. There's so many people playing Bloodborne, Dark Souls 3 right now, so it's kinda hard to get any viewers from me. So therefore, I come up with a brilliant plan. Which was, I'm not going to die. But I already ruined this plan by dying. So I have to come up with something else. Oh, I know what I will do. I will be the person who dies the most times. Kinda wanna kill those guys because throwing the bowls or vases is pretty ridiculously strong. No! Shouldn't jump there. And I don't wanna die now, because I'll lose all the 8,000 souls then. Really stupid. No! You're not gonna kill me now, dude. Forget about that, dude. Great great thing. Don't know how to pronounce it. Machete. There's actually a movie called Mach. Yeah, no. It's with the guy from Dusk Till Dawn, the guy who has like a million scars in his face and looks like he burned his face in fire. And is like the nicest person ever, I guess. wonder if I can already invade people now. Because I found a Covenant item. Oh. Like the only thing I really don't like now is that it seems... Don't even wanna read the messages. Fuck your messages. Don't wanna spoil anything for me. Threat is pretty strong. But it does not have much health. ...10,000 souls, that's like half of the souls that I need for the key. And here's another bonfire that I can just rest at, so... I can just get all the flasks back. Which is really good for me, I guess. There's a way there. So this is now new for me, I didn't go there yet. So I'm not sure what awaits me here. Parry! No, I fucked it up. I didn't have the shield equip. Do it again. Oh, almost. Ha! Skills are real. And no surviving by minus 10 hit points this time. Okay. This looks like a secret way, but it isn't. Like, there was not really a boss here, so I wonder. I know that. I actually saw that in the trailer. There is the giant that actually shoots the arrows here. But does that mean I actually need to go back to him? I need to go back, I think. But I killed all the enemies now, so it shouldn't be that difficult to get back. Get up to the tower and, you know, talk to him, and then he should actually stop throwing those or shooting those arrows. What, the rats are back? Oh no, I rested the bonfire. Oh no, I fucked up. I totally forgot that I rested the bonfire. So all the enemies are back. It sucks pretty much. But I think you can just wait because they will go away. Oh, the dog just fell down there. And those guys are actually really scary. You have to avoid those bows. Yeah, once they throw the bows, they're actually not that scary because you can just easily run away from them. The bows, you know, once they hit you, they have a ridiculous pushback and they can easily, you know, push you into the hole or into the abyss here. So anyway, I need to make that go down. So I call the other one, you know, and then I can go up and talk to the giant, which looks like the giant from Dark Souls DLC. So it's kinda cool to see old friends again, and I totally fucked it up. No, it's okay. I think it's okay. I was confused because there's actually a hidden way here. But I'm right here at the giant. So let's talk to him. Hello, my friend.
Help anytime.
Yeah, then.
I help anytime.
Then stop. Please, then stop shooting those arrows, please. So now he should stop, I guess. Not sure. I'm really not sure. Ooh! hope he's stopping now. Well, at least I cannot hear him shooting the arrows, so it might be a good sign, because otherwise, normally, I think, you will hear that he shoots. And why is he in the bridge here? Go away. No, fail plunge attack. No. Run away. Run away. No, 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 no. What the fuck? Fuck me. No. That actually means I have to do it all over again, because and I will now respawn at the new bonfire where I just went to. Which is a little bit annoying, but I guess it's okay. And maybe I should actually kill at least, you know, the rats in the sewers, so this cannot happen again. What was actually here? Was there a door, or was this just an item? No, there was nothing here. I think I should kill the rat, and maybe I can do a imba plunging attack. Kinda wanna try it, but hopefully it doesn't fail. Ah, it failed already. No, 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 no. Not lose the souls here. Fuck. It's chasing me. Okay, it can fight it because it will not lose the souls. Oh, that was a bad decision here. It's just way too many rats, way too many rats. Does this rat also drop amber, like humanity, you know, in Dark Souls? Like in Dark Souls 1, the rats would actually drop humanity. Kinda curious, what's the drop? Would make sense, you know, at least. Soul of a distorted corpse, okay. But maybe it also can drop something else, you know. Maybe there's like a rare drop and a normal drop and a super rare drop. Oh. Stop it. Ooh, then I know what the boss is. Oh no, I know what the boss is. Like, I got at least some spoilers from the trailer. Oh fuck, those guys are crazy. Like, I watched the trailer, you know, there was a trailer or some gameplay of this, and I know already what the boss is now, which is bad, and which makes me wonder if the decision to save the 20,000 souls is right, because the boss might be pretty ridiculous, and I don't want to lose all the souls. But I feel like I'm already strong enough, so I would not mind. You know, I just don't want to lose it because of the key that I can actually get.
I help.
Okay, then stop attacking, please. You can actually roll into those guys and stagger them by rolling. Oh no, I was slightly too far away. Kinda wanna save the blood vials. Not blood vials, the flasks. So I cannot rest at the bonfire, otherwise the dialogue with the giant. I think you wanna get parried again. Okay, now I fucked it up. Okay. Oh fuck. No. Maybe I should kill the guy first. I have to do the dialogue again. That's pretty stupid. That is pretty stupid. Pretty stupid. But what can you do? Nothing. Okay, I'm not gonna parry him. I'm just gonna get the souls first and kill him. If he's that strong, or I can just... Oh, but he actually staggers you just by running into you. Or even attacks you. Okay, we'll do it again. This is really bad. Just rest at the bonfire. Losing like 3 Estus flasks already, and I didn't even explore the new area. Not good enough. Not good enough. No, no. Like they make the same sounds like the crystal giants would make if you could kill them, which is kind of strange, you know. Now, Imba plunging attack version 2. Hopefully, I don't fuck it up this time. Imba plunging attack, and I forgot to. Oh, I made it! Kinda surprised myself. I thought I would just fuck it up again, because I had to think about what button to press while jumping, and I was not sure if I pressed it in time. Bowls of death. What? Fuck, he was... Fuck, did you see that? No, don't die here. No, 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 no! Did you see that? He was just faking the throw. And then he did not throw. And then he threw the fucking bowl. Huh. It totally got me off guard. Okay, come on. I can do this. Not that hard. So basically I need to go back to the giant, and I need to kill the rats, otherwise it will screw me over later, I think. Nice. Did you see that? But it was rather by... it's rather luck, I think. dog, I forgot about him. I don't wanna lose the souls. 12,000 is a lot. Key's like 20,000. No, 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 please not, please not, please not. Have mercy. No. Oh, it's coming down. Didn't expect that. Ooh. Parry. Almost nice try, but close. Titanite shard. Okay. So by now I actually upgraded the... Oh, he's also here. By now I already upgraded the katana to plus 4. So I would need like large titanite shards, but I think it's already a little bit too powerful. Because those enemies are like, you know, like taking a little bit way too much damage from my weapon. We'll just run. Get the souls back. Maybe we should just farm for those 20,000 souls and buy the key. So we don't lose them fighting, getting into the new area. I think that's maybe really smart actually. But rather boring. Well, let's see, maybe I get the 20,000 soul on the way to the boss. Okay, now, if I talk to the giant, he should no longer shoot arrows, which should make the next area a lot easier. Almost died there. Okay, finally, back to the new area, and the only thing, I think I did not kill the other big guy, so now I don't want to die to him again. Maybe not even fight him, but he's actually not that hard, I don't even know why I died the first or the last try. I guess I will just kill him because maybe he chases me and then it makes it really annoying to enter this area. No! No, no, no. So hopefully he will not shoot the arrows now. Oh no, he's shooting again? Why is he shooting the arrows? He told me to. Oh, he helps me now. Does he not shoot me? damage does nothing at all, though. Really nothing. Huh. I'm not sure if he actually shoots me. Hopefully not, because he told me he helps me, I guess. He's not shooting me. No. I think if he would shoot me, he could shoot me from here. Hopefully. Ah, he shot the enemy. Okay, he's really helping me now. Not sure if I can trust him actually. Shot me. Okay, I cannot trust him. He will just shoot anything, basically. Dude, why are you telling me you're helping me and then you're trying to kill me? Young White Branch. No! Oh no! Oh no! Okay, but at least I know he will shoot me anyway, so I don't have to go back and talk to him. Because that was, you know, I was like thinking if I talk to him and then go there without dying, he would not shoot me and would just, I don't know. But that's not how it works. Souls, got it back. Okay. Oh, I got the thing. Actually need to jump over there. So where's the hole? Where's the hole? Jump. Undead bone shard. Wait. Read the item description, but I kinda wanna get away from this place. It scares me a little bit. He's not shooting actually at me right now. Maybe he's really helping me. Maybe once you talk to him, he will always help you. Just in case he might shoot, I'm gonna wait here and read this item description. What is undead bone shard? I think it was something for the bonfire. Burn in shrine bonfire decrease Estus recovery. Okay, this is basically making your Estus flask. It's basically the I don't know what it was called, like, in Dark Souls, but something like Ash. I don't know. Don't remember. Okay. Oh, there's one more item here. Mortician's ashes. What is that? What is that? Oh. Why do I have like one and three in the inventory? It's the same item. Oh, there it is. Oh, shrine handmaid will prepare new items. Ah, I see. This is the item for the shop maids, or for the, you know, for the shop woman in the shrine. And once you give it to her, you will basically level her up and she will sell you better items. What? What? Where are you? I only or almost expected something like this. It's like typical Souls. Blue wooden shield, cleric hat, cleric robe, and basically the cleric set. Okay. I guess that is all that is here. Is like are like homing arrows. Oh, hey, don't shoot me. Where does this lead to? Huh. Don't think you can jump over there. Nah, no way. No way. Go in the house here. There's like some stronger enemies, because all the stronger enemies will have red eyes. That's maybe like the red versions of the enemies. Like New Game Plus will maybe have more of them, which is hopefully it will have more of them, would be pretty cool, because I was really disappointed when Bloodborne did not have like, what is it? Did it already fight something like that? I'm not sure. Oh, it's the guy with the daggers, I think. Looks like not prepared. Or the jumping attack! Not prepared. No one is prepared for the jumping attack. Hmm, how would you get over there? Guess you have to jump here on this little platform and jump! Yeah. This was also the item I think I saw from outside, yeah. I got the scythe! Oh my god, that's cool. Oh, let's see. Because it should be a skill weapon and I should be able to use it. No. I need 14 more strength. It's actually a skill weapon, but I need more strength to use it. I will definitely upgrade my strength next. After I buy the key. So it might take some time until I get there. How much strength do I have? Like 11, so I need like 3 more. Oh, that's cool. What does it say? Oh, it actually has the skill neck strap. I read it. I read this in the loading stream. This tech aims for the gruff of a foe's neck, and when successful, functions as a headshot. Sounds pretty promising. Inflicting heavy damage. Scared. This does not look good. I'm expecting the floor will collapse and I will fall to the boss or some shit. I see. This is the shortcut to the other way. So I can basically go to the other bonfire now, which will make this another way to the boss a lot easier. So I no longer have to go through the fucking area where the friend actually helps me by shooting at me. And this looks like a secret wall. But it isn't. This looks really strange. And this is definitely boss area. So I guess I will not go there now until I have those 20,000 souls, because I wanna buy the key and, you know, just spend those souls and not lose it. Because I will definitely lose it if I go to the boss right now. Where are the enemies here? There were like shit tons of enemies here normally. Like, why is he surviving when it's... Oh, because it did not dual wield it. Might drop a hammer if you're lucky. It's parry time. Oh, not this attack, do the air attack. Oh, there was two. Early, because these attacks are really delayed. Kinda hard to parry. Parry. Oh, it was close at least. No, okay. Maybe it's not parry time, maybe it's just kill him time. Oh, that was too fast. Expecting a more delayed attack. Yeah, it's parry time. It has to be parry time. Okay, it's not parry time. It's definitely not parry time. Had enough of this. Wait, where is actually the other bonfire that I'm thinking about? Ah, okay. Wait. Let me think. I think best bonfire still might be the one behind the sewers. Well, actually, I think I might actually have already enough souls if I use the, you know, the souls that you can pop. Let's see, because I don't really want to farm. I hate farming anything in any game. Hey, Mr. Johannes Marsling, how did you get it one day early? I actually got it on Saturday. Do you think I would be in the second area if I got it today? No, it took me like 10 hours to beat the first area. And I think it was a present by God because he knew that I'm such a nice person and he thought, well, this guy deserves to get Dark Souls 3 on Saturday, not on Tuesday, like all ordinary people, because he's not an ordinary person, he's a very special person. Okay, now here's the rat actually. The first area is pretty ridiculous, I can tell you. Not the tutorial area, but the first area is really hard actually. Because the enemies here, where is the. Ah, the rat is behind there, I think it is. Is it? Yeah, it is. Ah, no, I'm just gonna die here. Well, this red actually gives a oh, large soul. This red actually gives a lot of souls, so if I would have to farm a little bit here, it might make sense to do it with the big red actually. So I will just use all the souls that I have, and I should have enough, I think. And then, if I need to farm a little bit more, I will farm, but I'd rather, you know, use the those. And I should have enough because I picked up so many little souls. It should be enough. So I just want to buy the key, and then I can actually go to two new areas, or maybe actually three new areas after the boss. Okay, let's see. Should really be enough souls here. 2000, yeah. Easy peasy. Don't even have to use the small ones, I think. Yeah, see? 20,000 souls, and I buy the key now. I think I'm gonna buy it now so I can play it at 24 tonight. Well, actually, you know, I just read the news and it says Dark Souls 3 will sadly enough not be available at 20 at, you know, Monday night because they actually fucked something up. So all the ordinary people have to wait 2 more days if they wanna buy it online. Dark Souls 3 looks like Bloodborne 2. It's not like Bloodborne 2, but it's definitely not like the ordinary Dark Souls. It's a little bit different, actually. It's interesting. Like, this area is a little bit too easy for my taste. But, like I said, the first area, oh, it was really hard, actually. Like, all the normal enemies, like, there's knights who totally fuck you up. That's so ridiculous. And it's not like in Dark Souls, where Dark Souls 2, where you can just swing the sword, you know, like mad and spam and kill them. That's not gonna work out. It's not work. It will just destroy you if you do that. So you have to be more smart here in this game. Yeah, it definitely has a very Bloodborne strong influence. And now let's go to the.
Ah, well met, Ashen One. How may I be of service?
I have some old ashes of someone here.
Gracious, passing fine ash thou hast given. Let this ash bestow nourishment. I only hope these new wares content thee.
Let's see. I can also sell items, let's see, because I think I should have like. Wow, I get one soul for selling the rubbish. Really good. Because I think I picked up some armor sets really often. Yeah, like this one, I picked Lothric Night Helm up, like, and that's really cool. You can sell items right away, you know, so you can clear your inventory and also get some souls at least. It's the same one, yeah. Worker garb. Worker garbage. Oh, I actually might have better gloves here. and you can no longer upgrade the armor, which is so good, I think, you know. You can only upgrade the shields now and the weapons. So no more upgrading the armors. Armor sets. Okay. So let's buy. So she sells three additional embers. Embers is actually the equivalent, the same thing like humanity in Dark Souls. Basically the same thing, but the only difference is that you can only use it once. Like in Dark Souls, like, you know, you could just pop all the humanities for health, and here you can only use it once if you're not in kinda human form. And it also will refill all the HP, and you will have a little bit more HP than normally if you're undead. But after that point, if you already are human or in ember form, you can no longer use it again to, you know, refill your health. And now I wanna actually... No, there's like two more keys. A key to door in undead settlement sewer. Oh, I can actually buy it. Well, I'm so lucky. I can also buy the key to the tower behind the shrine. Oh, I wanna go there. And what does she have besides dagger or talisman? Okay, so basically the most important thing to get with the ash was the it's the grave key. Was the sewer key, I think.
Ashen one, be sure to bring.
Okay, now I can actually go to the boss because I have no souls to lose. Wasn't there another item that I just wanted to give someone? I'm not sure. Actually, there is another thing I wanted to check because I think I actually called one more NPC into the Firelink Shrine. This guy was already here. Turtle guy was also already here. Maybe it's on the other side. But I cannot remember which guy it was. Ah, I remember, it was the Pyromancer. Here he is.
Ah, there you are, unkindled. I wish to express my gratitude for trusting the lowly pyromancer and allowing me to gaze upon this majestic flame. As promised, I will impart pyromancies to you. But first, you'll need a flame of your own.
I don't have a flame of my own. Oh, okay, he gives it to me.
Careful,
thank you.
You don't burn yourself with it.
Actually, let me just check something.
Do not be gone for long. What is a teacher without a pupil?
Because I think you can already use like the pyromancy flame acts now as a weapon, if I'm right. And you can already use like all the weapons, you know, have the weapon arts. And yeah, so this pyromancy flame has already the combustion spell, you know, built in. So if you equip it and press L2, can already do the combustion, which is pretty cool because it's a pretty good spell, a very good spell actually, I think one of the best spells in Dark Souls, especially for PvP, because you can basically, you know, deny the enemy his guard and blocking. So
there you are. I am pleased to have a pupil as dedicated as you.
Welcome. Learn pyromancies, the fireball, Fire Surge, Great Combustion, Flash Sweat, pretty standard. Okay, only sells those pyromancies. Ah, okay, I have to go to Pyromancy Crown, Pyromancy Garb, Pyromancy Wrap, Pyromancy Trousers. So if you wanna upgrade the pyromancy flame. You will use titanite shards now. Okay, I see. So you no longer need like the, you know, the, I think it was a fire seed or something that you would need in, at least in Dark Souls 2.
Do not think I'm
Wait,
alone.
I didn't even pay attention. What does the pyromancy flame scale with? It basically scales with magic and, no, basically with intelligence and faith now. That's kind of interesting. Because it's strange, it never scaled with anything, you know, normally it would be just a spell that you could use even if you wouldn't skill any intelligence or faith, because it's all its basic power or its base damage would just determined by the strength of the pyromancy flame itself. Okay. Now let's see, I think I saw when I bought the key that I have better outfits, like, yeah, it's a lot better. I don't want it to be too heavy, and this one seems pretty decent. It has no curse. Yeah, I think it's pretty good for the weight. Cause I wanna be really fast and not, you know, too slow with the a lot of equipment load. Deserter trousers. Maybe there's better ones. Cleric trousers. Ah, I don't like cleric trousers. And even worse. Besides on the resistances. No, I don't like the stuff. I think they're pretty decent right now. I have like two deserter armors, I could sell one basically. And this one has a lot more weight. This one has even less weight but less physical damage. Okay, let's just sell the deserter's armor so I don't stack up on unnecessary items.
Oh, how?
It's only 30.
Ashen one.
Okay, let's go to the boss. This one will be interesting. Like, I think the first boss, I mean, the very first boss was not too hard, but also kinda, you know, a little bit challenging. And then the second boss in the first real area, I think that was just way too easy. So I'm kinda interested how the next boss will be, because the, like I said, where do I need to go here? I think this one is the right, yeah, this one is the right bonfire. So like the second boss was a little bit too easy for me, I didn't like that, you know, like when he got into second phase, yes, he was a lot faster, but still he would die way too fast and it was not so challenging, I think. So I would like to be Dark Souls 3 a little bit more difficult sometimes. Let's see. Not gonna kill the rat now, I'm just gonna skip them. Just gonna run here. Gonna save all the flasks for the boss. I already know what the boss is, but I don't know what it does actually, you know, because I watched some stuff on the internet. But I think this should really be the last spoiler of the game. See the tree here. looks a little bit strange, doesn't it? And he gets worshipped. Why would he get worshipped? Yeah, indeed, this area actually reminds me a little bit of the area where you fight Garmin because of the flowers. Always one of the red eyes. It's a little bit stronger, but like I said, I already upgraded the cat. Yeah, it's the boss. It's pretty nasty. I also have to kill the other guys now. I really don't know what it does, so be careful. We just killed. What's doing? No, get away! Can only hit him at third area of his body. What is the new guy spawning? Maybe this egg thing is the way where he can actually hit him. Let's see? Yeah, that's the 3 points. Oh my god, he gets almost no damage! Also like doing the acid thing like coming down there. missed actually all the opportunity. Yeah, it's actually pretty easy. Just wait until it falls over. Can do all the damage to him. I think it's not safe to attack him if he doesn't fall. Where's the arm? Ah, there it is. Transposing. You, I did it. That was really easy. I don't know, you know. Like, this was really easy. Really, really easy. Let's see what the transposing kill is. It's a key item. Make soul transposition possible. What does that mean? I don't even know. An old transposing kiln from Corland, crafting with stitched crystal lizard hide. Gift to Ludlef, Lord of Cinder, to conduct soul transposition. This kiln can transpose twisted souls to craft special items with the concentrated essence. Deemed forbidden by those unable to make proper use of it. Although this is basically the, you know, the ember that you would need for making boss weapons, I guess. But I think I've never. Did I actually meet Ludlef? I'm not sure. I already was here actually before. Before I fought the boss, there's a way to get here actually. Just wanna read the messages, don't wanna spoil myself, you know. I wanna find an Odus on our bonfire here, and he died. Lonely. He's dead now. Why is he dead now? No. So this is like a covenant here, and like I said, I already visited this guy, and he gave me the like all. all the covenants are different, like in Bloodborne, where you equip them now. Right now I have the Way of the Blue, but he gave me the Pledge oneself into the Mount Maker's Covenant, and this seems to be like a PvP covenant where you can actually invade others by, you know, like more like the, I think it was like the Aline rune, where we would either spawn as an helper or even enemy, and I think here we will always spawn as enemy, I think. I'm not sure actually, but it sounds like that if you read it. I'm really curious. He's dead. What? Why is he dead? Lonely. So does that mean that I actually got the item now? Or maybe it actually means that, you know, if you would not meet him before, you would get the item now, I guess. Or maybe you wouldn't get the item, but I guess you would get the item now. Well, let's get back to the Firelink Shrine. Pit of Hollows. Like I watched Eli Cho, he's also a streamer, fighting this boss, and he died so many times. You know, I just watched it a little bit, like maybe 1 minute, and then stopped the stream because I didn't want to spoil myself. And every time I actually, you know, watched what streams were available, I saw that he was still fighting this boss, and I was like, oh my god, this boss has to be really difficult, but it was really easy, as you just saw. You know, if you just stay patient and don't play stupid and don't attack like stupid, you know, if you have some souls experience, then this boss is easy peasy. Now, where's Ludlath? Maybe she tells me something now.
Welcome home, Ashen One. Speak thine heart's desire.
He's there now.
May the flames guide thee.
See that? So you basically summon him after killing the boss.
All that unkindled, and a seeker of lords. I am Ludlath of Corlan. Look not in bewilderment as I say. I linked the fire long ago, becoming the Lord of Cinder. If substantiation be thy want, set thine eyes upon my charred corpse. This sad cadaver, no need to be coy. Have a closer look.
Guess I give this thing to him?
Oh, belike it is a transposing kiln in thy possession. Seen better days, but methinks it shall suffice. Now, bring to me a twisted soul. Transposition is the art of extracting and coalescing the essence of a soul. In transposing a twisted soul, its true power transferreth to thee. Thy purpose is to seek lords and slay them. What's to fear in a little transposition now?
Let's begin transposition. Ah, okay, I see. So you can... Soul of the Rotted... I have that. Oh, I have that, yeah. Ah, you can basically make now weapons from this. Like I thought. And you can also make rings. And even spells. Great sword, that's a Hollow Slayer from the tree. but I don't, you know, will not use greatsword, so it's not. But it also skills with dexterity. Demon's Great Axe. I need soul of a demon. Oh, you can basically make a spear or a sword. Demon's Fist. I don't want any demon's fists. Soul of a demon. What soul of a demon? So I'm just gonna skip here and not make anything.
Knowest thou of our purpose? Five thrones will take five lords as kindling for the linking of the fire. The fast fading flame must be licked to preserve this world. A reenactment of the first linking of the fire. So it is, I became a lord of Cinder. I may be but small, but I will die a Colossus. Knowest thou of our purpose?
So these guys, these kings, are basically the guys who kindled the fire. You know, like in Dark Souls 1, you did it, in Dark Souls 2, and each one of those also did it. And your purpose is basically to kindle or stop the vanishing of the flame again. And I'm just wondering, because I killed like two bosses now, like Bortz or whatever he's called, if he also summoned a Cinder. Say anything else?
Ooh, yet to give in, eh? Good. The firekeeper must be twitching with delight. But what do you really know about these lords of Cinder, these supposed legends? Let's take Aldrich for one. A right and proper cleric. Only he developed a habit of devouring men. He ate so many that he bloated like a drowned pig, then softened into sludge. So they stuck him in the Cathedral of the Deep, and they made him a Lord of Cinder, not for virtue, but for might. Such as a lord, I suppose. But here I ask, do we have a sodding chance? At the foot of Lothric Castle, an old path still runs below the tower in the undead settlement. It was used to transport sacrifices to the Cathedral of the Deep. You should see where it leads, if you've the stones for it.
What is talking about? Yeah, I know there's actually a door that is locked in the switch action. Okay.
You haven't given up yet. Then you're a brasher lad than I thought. You can make better use of this.
Heavy gem, nice.
I don't need it. Not now I've flown the coop. The undead Legion of Farum is a caravan of undead. Sworn by wolf's blood to contain the abyss, the Legion will bury a kingdom at the first sign of exposure. Joyous bunch, really. Gaining admission to the Legion is a matter of some ceremony. Inside their keep, snuffing out the flames of three altars opens the door to the wolf blood.
What?
Even accursed undead want to believe they're special, it seems. I pity the sorry souls. Gaining admission to the Legion is a matter of... even I.
Okay, so basically he repeats himself from now on. Now let's see if there is another guy here. There's no one here. No one here, I think. Yeah, I think that's the only one that I just... Who is he? What is he? I don't remember him at all.
Unkindled, are we? And fast on the trail of the Lords absconded? Then these red eyes are for you.
Cracked dry red eye orbs, nice. I can invade someone.
Use them to pillage embers and briefly heighten your strength for your duty. What else are unkindled ashes good for? Pillage embers for brief. What else are un.
Okay. Yeah, so that's the only one here now. I don't even remember where I met this guy, or maybe he just appears here after a certain point in the game. There's a crack in the wall, or is it just now? It's just the way to this guy. Now I remember that I could actually burn the ashes for a better Estus flask. Also got like something for the smith, because you can get more Estus flasks from him.
Ah, it is good to see you. What needs smithy?
Like reinforce? No, I need a Estus shard, but I don't have one.
Pretty, be careful.
Okay. So, I'm wondering actually. Like he told me something about there's a. Yeah, I saw there's actually a door in the lottery castle that I couldn't open yet.
Ah, well met, Ashen One. How may I be of service?
How may you be of service? Actually, not at all.
Ashen One. Well,
I will just spend the souls to level up, to get, you know, to level 14 to be able to use the scythe.
Speak very well, then take not.
Level up once. Sadness.
Farewell, Ashen One.
But I have enough souls that I can pop to level up at least twice. Oh, that's for. Okay, I guess I will be able to level up two more times. And then I have 14 strength, which I need for the scythe.
Welcome home, speak. Very well, then talk Hagna.
Okay, I need. Oh, it's actually working. Perfect.
Farewell, Ashen.
Nice. Let's have a look at the scythe. Really curious. And, you know, you have this this weapon art. Oh, this one. Okay, it's basically just one attack. And you can see that it actually costs mana. Which gives you the headshot ability. I'm curious what it, if it really, you know, cuts off their heads. Upgrade it also. So I can just use the rest of the souls. Upgrade it twice. How much is it? Required souls? 410, yeah. It gets slightly more careful. Expensive, so I'm missing like 10 souls. Maybe I can sell some bullshit like firebomb or so. Let's just sell one repair powder or two. And if I sell a little bit more, I should actually be able to upgrade it 3 times. Since I think you can buy unlimited repair powder, I can just sell it. It's not that important right now for me.
Ashen one.
It is good to see ye in good health. What need?
Old requires 4 titanite shards. Fuck. Oh no. Didn't see that before. Don't think can I buy somewhere? No.
Pretty, be careful.
Like maybe she sells some now.
Oh, how?
I don't think she does. No. Okay.
Ashen one.
Well, I guess then. This has to do.